now. Washington Mornings on the Mall.
105.9 FM.
At AM 630.
WMAL.
637 on WMAL, where Washington comes to talk. It's Brian Wilson in with Tori Clark today, and for Mr. Neiman, who's on parental leave. Be back later this week. Tori, good to have you.
Great to be here.
On the line is our good friend Joe DeGeneva, our legal analyst. And Joe, you come to us. Are you in Paris?
We are not only in Paris, France, but we are on the Île de Saint-Louis near the Notre Dame Cathedral. And not far from here is the court where the royal family is suing this morning.
That's right. Well,
timing is everything,
yeah,
Joe.
And that's topic number one this morning. Now, for those who haven't followed, and I don't know how you could have missed this, because it's everywhere, there have been some naked pictures taken of Kate Middleton while she and Prince William were on vacation. And they were sunbathing, in the nude, or at least she was topless. Let's put it that way. Pictures are taken from a long-distance lens, maybe several football fields away. They're not particularly crisp and clear pictures, but they are pictures.
Not that you've looked at them extensively, Brian Wilson.
Listen, I had a news interest in knowing this.
That's the only France. Mais non.
That's right.
So anyway, the
royals are furious about this, and because they were published in a tabloid in France, they are thinking about filing suit. What's the latest, and do they have a case?
They do have a case. Under French law, there is an expectation of privacy, which you can enforce against a publisher and get an injunction to prevent further publication, and you can also seek fines against the publisher, which can be huge fines, tens of thousands of euros, and they are going to do it. And my guess is they're going to win. They do have a very substantial case because they were in a private residence in the south of France. They had a complete expectation of privacy, according to some people that I've talked to in France here who follow these things, including some journalists. I think the French journalists are pretty much appalled by this, as are the English. But what's really gotten to the French is that this is where Diana died. Mm-hmm. And because of the paparazzi and the problem, and they think this is the beginning of a bad scene. And so, believe me, the newspapers in France have no friends on this issue.
Now, if this were to happen in the United States, would it be different?
That's exactly what I was going to say.
You could not get an injunction. You might be able to sue in a civil court to get damages for invasion of privacy, but you could not prevent future publication. That is impossible under our First Amendment law. But not only are they doing that, not only are they suing this morning, not far from here, but they are seeking a criminal case against the photographer. And the French have indicated preliminarily that if they can identify the photographer, they're going to prosecute him under the French criminal laws.
Well, we'll know who the photographer is, right? I'm sure there's going to be a credit with the photos in this spread.
These were sold to them. There is no credit right now, but I think what's going to happen is the newspaper that published them is going to be forced to give up the name.
Right. So here's a strategic question. In this 24/7, always-on information environment in which we exist, can anyone, whether it's a private citizen or a public citizen, have expectations of privacy?
Well, you can under certain circumstances, but I think you make a very important point, Tori, which is, beware wherever you are. I think under the circumstances in this case, they had a reasonable expectation of privacy. But if you're out in general public places or on beaches or in wildly open areas, I think, you're pretty much in the danger zone, and there's not much you can do about that.
It's interesting. We have photographers with these telephoto lenses that can take pictures from several football fields away. We have cameras everywhere in the District of Columbia to take pictures of us when we maybe go a few miles over the speed limit. And yet we can't get a decent picture of the new panda cub this morning for some reason. I don't know why.
Well, the truth is privacy is getting to be a very difficult thing to maintain. And I think in this case, though, the royals have a very, very good case. The French lawyers who've been commenting on this on television have been pretty strong about this. Also, the British journalists have... One fellow who was a very, very well-known journalist last night, he said, just think about this for a second. If that was a telephoto lens on a rifle, just think how dangerous their situation was.
Brian Wilson,
I think that's also playing into this, is that the security problems surrounding this are very substantial, And I think the security around Kate and Andrew is going to change dramatically.
You know, I said the same thing before we came on the air this morning. I said if it were a sniper scope, it'd be a whole different thing. It's a security problem as well.
It's scary to think of it.
All right, I want to turn to another story. Now, we got an email from a guy who's a Fairfax County fireman.
And, I read it.
And so, yeah, he says he's being asked to wear a pink T-shirt because of his regular uniform to show support for the Susan G. Komen Foundation.
Right.
And he says, of course, you know, the idea here is to show raise awareness for the issue of breast cancer. But because he and others are Catholic or they just don't want to support a foundation that gives money to Planned Parenthood, they sort of are resisting. Do they have to wear the pink T-shirt? And what happens if they don't want to wear the pink T-shirt? Shirt and they, you know, somebody gets on them about it.
They do not have to wear the pink T-shirt. It is not part of their uniform. It is not part of their official duties. It is not covered in their union contract. And if they are forced to wear it, they can sue for damages. They can sue for all sorts of other things. This is really stupid on the part of the fire department. Remember what they're doing. They're forcing people to say something. It's called the First Amendment. You can't force people who are public employees to say things they do not want to say. And you can't force private employees to say things that they don't want to say. So this is a no-brainer. If he doesn't want to wear it and they take action against him, this gentleman's going to own a second home.
Wow. But you know how this works. Everybody's being asked to go along with it. And if
sure. You're
the guy...
And they might say we're not forcing him to do it. We just wish that everybody would do it.
Yeah.
Well, from henceforth, every action... In their organization taken against him will be seen through the lens of retaliation, and that will be for them the worst of all possible worlds for purposes. A bunch of school children just came by to go to the hearing on the Prince and Princess. It's the worst possible situation for them. It also shows an incredible lack of judgment on their part that they would force public employees to do something like this. I can't imagine that we haven't heard from the union yet. I mean, this is so remarkably unprofessional and just basically stupid as a matter of public policy.
Wow. No
strong
doubt
letter
in your
to
mind.
Follow.
Yeah, that's right.
Oh, no. Listen, this is what we call black letter law. You cannot force people to say things as public employees that they do not want to say. You know what? If that were the case, they could say, by the way, the United Way collection is underway and you are going to give $100. And if you said no, they said, "Oh, I'm sorry, you're going to give it. It's coming out." Well, can't do that either. So this is this is actually more important. This is speech. You're wearing a shirt that says something, and they're forcing you to say something that you don't agree with.
All right, Joe DeGeneva, very strong on that issue.
Yes, reporting from Paris.
That's
reporting
right.
Reporting from Paris.
This is Paris, where they have rowdy school children walking the streets.
But they're lovely children. They're going to have wine for lunch.
There we go. All right, Joe. Thanks. Enjoy Paris.
Take care.
All right?
We will, guys. Take care.